Thank you. Now then. Tis I. The situation may be more complicated than we anticipated.
Indeed, I shall remain watchful. Ere thou goest, another matter requireth thine attention. A young maiden, full eager to... Wherefore inquirest thou of her fairness? Ugh, very well. Be she damsel or devil, I shall direct her steps to Revenant's toll. Save thine insinuations for one given to such impropriety. Thou shalt not find me amenable.
Far across the sea from the land of Domar have we traveled. We seek audience with the ruler of these lands. Who here speaks for you?
Thank you.
We have traveled some several thousand miles across the sea, from the nation of Domar, in hopes that we might find sanctuary in these lands.
Sanctuary, Lady Yugiri?
Aye. Lying within Othard, Domar was under the dominion of the Galian Empire, as I'm sure you are aware. When the War of Succession broke out in Garlemald, we espied an opportunity to free ourselves from the yoke of Imperial oppression and took up arms. Only to be crushed. And so I gathered what few Domans escaped the reckoning and guided them hither to your shores.
A War of Succession? Then the Emperor... Forgive me. You said that Doma was under Imperial rule, did you not?
Doma is gone. Raised to the ground as an example to the other provinces.
12 have mercy. And your people?
On a ship anchored in Vesper Bay, flying borrowed colors. Many were complicit in the rebellion, or akin to those who were. They will not come ashore until I send word that it is safe to do so. I sought an audience with your rulers, but was summarily refused.
The lords of Ulda are not wont to entertain foreign refugees without suitable encouragement.
Mayhap I was foolish to expect otherwise. But our supplies run low, and we have young ones in urgent need of care. I have seen the tents outside the gates, however. We are not the first to seek asylum, nor will we be the last.
Be that as it may, Ulda is no friend to Garlemald. Your tale would stir the hearts of many men and women here. The Sultana and the Syndicate will not be so easily swayed, but I shall see that you are granted an opportunity to plead your case.
This is within your power?
Well, far be it from me to boast, but I do have the ear of certain influential individuals.
I am in your debt.
Lady Yugiri, forgive me for observing, but your choice of attire seems like to evoke feelings of mistrust.
Men are wont to fear the unfamiliar. We know this from experience. We seek only to spare the people of Ulda unnecessary disquiet.
I shall defer to your experience, then.
I thank you for your understanding.
It seems I have urgent business with the Flame General. I leave our guests in your capable hands.
I, Yugiri of Domar, am honored to meet you at last, Your Grace. To mark this auspicious occasion, I should like to present to you the finest treasures our humble nation has to offer. Alas, the circumstances which have brought me here today have divested me of both time and dignity. I come before you as a pauper in direst need of aid, to request that you grant my people asylum.
I, Nanamo, 17th in the line of Ul, welcome you to our city. Be at ease, Lady Yugiri. Although I myself have heard the tale of your misfortune, I would ask that you recount it once more for the benefit of the others here present.
As you wish, Your Grace. For many years, my nation, Domar, suffered under the yoke of imperial rule, and my people yearned to be free. Thus, when a war of succession broke out in Garlemald, we sought to take advantage of the chaos and reclaim our liberty. Alas, our enemy proved less preoccupied than we had hoped, and our rebellion was put down in the most brutal fashion.
Those who survived, how many do they number?
More than 200 souls huddle within the cramped confines of our own galleon's hold. Yet this figure accounts for but one of a number of ships which escaped the Purge. It is my hope that you will allow us all to dwell within your walls. Should that prove unfeasible, however, I humbly ask that you accept as many of my people as your resources allow. Pray understand, we do not beg a boon, but propose instead an arrangement. We would serve as soldiers or tradesmen until our debt is repaid.
What are the Syndicate's opinions on this matter?
I, for one, think it's a marvelous idea. Lady Yugiri and her people strike me as an industrious lot, and there are parts of the city which have yet to be fully restored. If they are willing to work, I see no reason not to let them.
The head of the Mirage Trust is not known for his generosity. He sees profit in this.
I agree. That said, these are foreign refugees. To admit them would require a formal resolution. Shall we call a vote?
The law is the law.
Lord Lolorito? Tell me. Are you blind or willfully ignorant? Even now, our streets are choked with the displaced victims of the Calamity and Alamegan refugees. They live hand to mouth, subsisting on aid provided by the immortal flames, the cost of which grows ever higher. The wealth of Ulda is not without limits, my friends. And need I remind you that these refugees are prone to violence and criminal activity? You have all read the reports, I think. Without homes or employment, it is only a matter of time before men grow desperate and take that which they imagine has been unjustly denied them. Yet, knowing this, you would have us swell their ranks. Mayhap you think the brass blades and the flames are not hard-pressed enough?
Or it may simply be that he's ruthless beyond reckoning.
Surely the Sultanate can support the few hundred domains Lady Yugiri represents. That our resources have been taxed, I do not deny. But we are hardly in danger of financial collapse. I move that an exception be made.
An exception, Your Grace?
I am suddenly reminded of a similar debate some years ago regarding a number of Alamegan refugees, if memory serves. What were your words that day? Ah, yes. The law is the law. And so our visitors remained in Little Alamego. Mayhap our wise and benevolent Sultana would be so good as to enlighten us as to which other of our laws should not be upheld.
Mind your tongue, Lolorito.
My lord, I share your concern for the welfare of our great nation, but we must endeavor to take a longer view. You know as well as I that people can be a resource still more precious than gil.
Precious or not, they were never yet so reliable. And unlike those who frequent your establishment, I have no desire to gamble with my future. Uldar's greatest asset is, and has ever been, her material wealth. We risk this at our peril. One need only look to Taleji Adeleji's example for evidence of the danger in allowing sentiment to dictate policy. How far the vaunted Mirage have fallen, both in repute and profitability since he began employing refugees.
My affairs is not your concern, my lord.
A proposal has been tabled. Given its urgency, I move we forego further debate and call a vote. To accept the Doman refugees or not, those in favor, I bid you remain. Those opposed, I bid you leave.
That it were within my power to welcome you and your people, Lady Yugiri. As you have observed, however, my authority in such matters is regrettably limited. Without the consent of the Syndicate, I cannot act.
I understand, Your Grace, and I appreciate all that you have done on our behalf.
The nerve of the man! If that bastard had not forsaken the eastern trade route, Little Alamego would now be thriving. Oh, that you should have traveled so far under such dire circumstances, only to be refused in this manner is utterly unconscionable. Pray, accept my sincerest apologies.
Now that the Empire no longer poses an immediate threat, they see little reason to maintain the pretense of unity. The Monitorists have grown especially defiant of late. Lord Lolorito most of all. But this is neither the time nor place for that discussion.
Thank you. How goes the fishing? Caught anything slippery?
Aye. Our suspicions were well founded. The Serpent Reavers are indeed the culprits.
The plot thickens.
Has there been any movement in Thanalan?
It has been blessedly quiet. Which is to say the Amalja are being no more or less of a nuisance than usual, summoning Ifrit with such crystals as they have hoarded. Urianger, too, reports not out of the ordinary.
Then we have our explanation.
Your explanation for what, pray tell?
For the recent spate of crystal thefts in Thanalan, we naturally assumed that the trail would lead us back to the Amalja. Yet it did not. It led us across the sea unto Vilbrand.
Vilbrand? There have been reports of increased Sahagin activity of late. Oh gods, they mean to summon Leviathan?
That is the way of it, I fear. Whilst conducting our investigation on behalf of the mineral concern, we came upon evidence implicating the Serpent Reavers. With the aid of the Maelstrom, I was able to verify our suspicions. 'Tis only a matter of time before Leviathan returns to harrow the seas. But there is more. One of the Sahagin, an elder by my judgment, spoke of attaining the gift and knowledge of eternity.
Ugh.
Such a disturbance in the ether. If I did not know better, I should think this device defective. And there is the explanation.
Soon. Soon it shall begin. Our Lord shall rise mid surging waves to wash away the finless ones. And I shall be granted the gift and knowledge of eternity, and with the emissary stand equal. Then shall I know no cessation, no oblivion.
Whence comes this promise of immortality? The emissary? We have outstayed our welcome.
The gift and knowledge.
Are the two of you quite well?
You shared that vision, did you not? Even before the Sahagin made mention of the emissary, I recognized Elidibus's words. He is behind this. But surely it is not within his power to grant the echo.
My lady, unless we act swiftly, Leviathan will rise again. The Admiral has already requested that we intervene to prevent this. Failing that, we are to attend to the Primal's extermination.
She will have our full cooperation. Let us make haste to Limsa Luminsa. I mean to play a part in this mission. Tataru, pray, take charge in my absence.
My lady, are you sure this is wise?
I am aware of the risks, but there is something I must see with mine own eyes. The true nature of the Echo.
Very well. I shall not stand in your way. On the condition that you permit me to accompany you as bodyguard.
Your company is ever welcome, Thancred.
I take it something ill is afoot.
Aye. A primal is about to be loosed upon Eorzea.
A primal?
A godlike being whose very existence is a bane upon the land. We scions of the Seventh Dawn are sworn to put an end to their kind. It would be most welcome. When contending with a primal, one can never have too many able allies. If you crave a more intimate understanding of the problems facing Eorzea, this experience is like to provide it. Be sure to come well prepared. damn them. They have made thralls of soldiers and civilians both.
Did I miss much? So that is how you fight in the Far East. Mental note, pick no quarrel with Domans. But seriously, if I am to keep up, I must needs forsake elegance for efficiency.
You'll forgive me my lateness.
I've been something of a liability of late, I know. It is high time I set about making amends.
Long have you shriveled sword walkers, tormented our kind. But no more! Your time is at an end! Salt in your wounds, and sea in your lungs. Lord of the world, hearken to our plea. Lord of the world, deliver us from our misery.
Do you feel that?
I know this sensation. It's the echo.
What?
Thank you.
strike me down if you will. It is futile. I have mastered the gift. I am eternal. Oh, mighty Leviathan, ruler of the sea, son of waters primordial. I offer unto you this frail flesh, that you might grant your faithful servants deliverance. I beseech you, come forth!
Die, damn you! A single ship. Hells take that sea demon. Gather the survivors and get to shore. Leave the wrecks for the pirates. Leviathan wastes no time. The diversionary squadron is lost. For a mercy, 'twould seem the Primal now makes for open sea. But why does he not press his advantage? Unless... God save us! He means to unleash a tidal wave!
Thank you. There used to be a hamlet beyond South Tidegate in Western Lanotia. Halfstone, 'twas called. Some years prior to the Maelstrom's founding, Leviathan rose from the briny depths and set about unleashing watery hell upon us. On that occasion, the company of heroes put him down before he could do too much damage. But when the bastard came next, this time in the wake of the calamity, we were not so fortunate. Weary of ravaging our shoreline, he summoned a tidal wave which fair leveled Halfstone and washed the soil away for good measure.
The area was subsequently occupied by the Sahagin.
Aye, the thrice-damned creatures transformed it into a spawning ground for their brood. Given the quantity of crystal stolen to feed him and his legion of thralls, we can be fairly sure that Leviathan is stronger now than in his previous incarnations. If that sea demon is left to wreak havoc, what befell Halfstone may well befall a larger settlement, even Limsa. That cannot happen. The primal must be stopped.
That was ever our objective, Admiral. But how are we to achieve it? The sea is Leviathan's uncontested domain. The ships of the 3rd Squadron could not close to within 100 yams of the Primal, nor could their cannons pierce his defenses.
I have read the reports, Master Thancred. Our warships may as well have been bloody pleasure barges for all the good they did. 7 hells! Is there no way that we might strike back?
The company of heroes defeated Leviathan, having first lured him into an inlet, but we must needs contend with him upon the open sea. It will avail us little to consult past experience.
Admiral, if I may.
Speak freely, Marshal.
By all accounts, Leviathan's most formidable weapon is the very sea itself. Waves and whirlpools, tides and currents, all these things are his to command. The key to victory, I believe, lies in disarming our foe. This, in effect, is what the company of heroes achieved with their ruse. We cannot lure Leviathan from the sea a second time. But what if we could weaken his hold upon the element of water? I have heard of devices capable of such wonders. They draw upon the power of corrupted crystals, I am told. If mounted upon a ship, such a device might be used to prevent Leviathan from bringing the full force of the sea to bear against us, rendering him no more dangerous than any other sea serpent.
Of course! Cid built a similar device to grant the Enterprise safe passage through Garuda's Tempest, did he not?
Begging your pardon, my lady, but to give credit where it's due, this is something I heard from an old Arcanist friend of mine.
It makes little difference who thought of it first, so long as it works. Beg the specifications of this device from your friend, and I shall pass them on to our people at Naldic and Vermelis. But before we proceed any further, I would voice one concern. Piercing Garuda's defenses is one thing. Suppressing Leviathan's attacks, quite another. In matters of science, I am as a babbling babe, but I cannot well imagine that such a feat would be possible without a veritable mountain of corrupted crystals. The question being, do we have a ship big enough to bear such a burden?
Mayhap not, Admiral, but two might. Recall you the tale of Mistbeard's greatest haul? It is said that he lashed two ships together, side by side, the better to bear his plunder. By your leave, we might attempt to repeat the trick. The gods know it would be quicker than building a new vessel.
Mistbeer did this. Truly, Marshal, upon the subject of the Pirate King, you are as a scholar.
Now, from what I have gleaned of these matters, the device will need to be in close and constant proximity to the target. To wit, we must lash our twin vessel to Leviathan. This in itself will be no small feat. Ramming speed will be required, but given the weight of the cargo, that will only be attainable with the aid of a towing vessel. Suffice it to say, the task of piloting said vessel will entail considerable danger, and I would not ask it of another. I volunteer myself.
It will be dangerous for all involved, but we have no better recourse. Very well. Commodore. Assemble the remnants of the fleet at Moraby Bay. Give priority to our soundest vessels. The repairs can wait. Storm Marshal Slafirson, command of the operation is yours. I want that twin vessel ready to sail post-haste.
At once, Admiral.
And then there is the small matter of slaying the beast. The fate of Limsa Lominsa rests upon your shoulders once again. Go well, Warrior of Light.
Thank you. Thank you.